Welcome to Draw and Design. Today I am going to design a concrete pedestal with steel elements in Revit. So watch the full video and don't forget to subscribe. I already set up the views and levels and then installed a short column with footing. On top of this, I will install a hollow steel vertical member, which we don't have in existing family. So I am going to load a family from structural column, steel, and then select HSS hollow column and then open this. Now I am going to attach this column in the center point of the existing short column. This column doesn't seem right, so I am going to select this column and then go to levels. So I will set up the bottom of this column to top of the foundation and top of this column to level 2 and then apply. As you can see, we have a very small gap between two columns. So this is for the base plate we will install later on. Now I am going to select the column, edit properties. I am going to rename this existing column and change from 8 inches to 12 inches. And then I will click OK. Now I will change the dimensions as well. Then apply and OK. Now I am going to install the steel base plate. I'm going to open steel, select the plate. Then from the draw tool, I will select rectangle and make a rectangle on existing concrete column. Then I will use offset with 2 inches and then select the boundary lines to make the inner offset of 2 inch. Then I will use trim or extend command and make the inner rectangle close. Then I will select the outer boundaries and delete. Now click on finish edit mode and you can see a very nice steel plate is installed between two columns. Now I am going to select the corner cut and select all the corners to make a nice chamfer. Now we need to make holes in this steel plate for anchors. To do so, I will use the detail line for the reference of steel anchors. I will select detail line with an offset of 2 inches. And select the pick line tool. I will select the outer line which will make it offset of 2 inches inside. The position of holes is at the intersection point of these detail lines. Now I will go to steel tab again and in the bolts drop down I will select holes. Then I will select the steel plate which we need to cut for holes. Then I will choose rectangle from draw tool and from the intersection of these detail lines I will draw a rectangle. Then click on tick mark and holes are cut. Now we need to install the stiffener plates. But the stiffener plates cannot be drawn in the cross section or the elevation. So we need to draw the stiffener plates in plan and then rotate them to align with the section. Now I will go to steel tab again and select the plate. I will select the rectangle from draw tool and then I will draw a rectangle for the stiffener plate. So I will make a 6 inch by 4 inch stiffener plate with a corner cut. So I will choose the line tool. And then cut the stiffener plate diagonally. Then use the trim extend command to close the boundary. And then finish edit mode. Now I will go to east elevation and rotate this stiffener plate. I will open up east elevation. Then I am going to select this stiffener plate and select the rotate command. Then I will place the rotational axis on the midpoint of column and then rotate the stiffener plate. And as you can see, our stiffener plate is at the place. Now I will make copies of this stiffener plate on all four sides. So first of all, I will select this plate and I will select pick axis and make on other side. Then I will use rotate command, place the rotational axis on midpoint and then rotate the stiffener plate to other side. Then I will again use mirror axis and place both stiffener plate on the other side. All four sides are covered with the stiffener plate. It's time to install the welds between these three items. The welds will join the stiffener plate to the base plate and the base plate to the column and the column to the stiffener. So the installation of stiffener welding is very easy. I will select the weld. I will select both items which we need to install the weld and then click OK and then select the edge line and weld is installed. So again I will repeat the process. I will select column, I will select base plate, click enter and then click on the edge line of column. So using this process I will install all the welds on all four sides and all three items. I will increase the speed of video to save the time. So during this process I am using pick axis tool, I am using rotate command, I am using copy command, but I am installing all the welds on all four sides and stiffener plates with the base plate. I am joining the base plate with the column and I am joining the column with the stiffener plate. So all joints are necessary. So after our stiffener plates are installed, now it's time to install the anchor bolts. So in order to do so, I am again using the detail line with an offset of 2 inches and select the pick line tool. And again I am using the same process as I have used in the making of holes. Then I will go to steel, select the bolt and drop down I will select the anchors. Then I will select the plate and then click enter and then I will use the rectangle tool and from the intersection of these detail lines I will draw a rectangle and then click on finish edit mode. That's very easy. So all of our bolts are on place. As you can see, our pedestal joint is ready. So there is a one very important thing you need to keep in the mind, that all the steel members are only visible in the fine detail level. So if you don't select the fine detail level, you cannot see any of the steel item. So make sure you select the fine detail level. So that's all. Our pedestal foundation is ready. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you enjoyed the video, please hit like button and please don't forget to subscribe my channel. See you in the next video.